I think that women, they tell a story. I think that they offer a solution. I think they promote peace. Not about winning, it's about peace. It's about people, it's about the community. It's about, you know, us living together in harmony. And I think that that's what women bring out in their work. And I think by keeping this narrative going of telling future generations of what once was and showing them what's happening now and offering them what could be.
Hi, Delita.
Hi, Brad. How are you?
I'm good. I was curious, because of this exhibition and the title of the exhibition, what did you think when you walked into the space for the first time and saw what was on display?
This is an amazing exhibition. It was very inspiring to me as a young artist, as a young female African-American artist. The women in this show are so diverse, but they all have this common thread of being visual storytellers and telling stories about their community, about their personal lives, and the things that touch them as women and as people in a global community.
Well, I know as we open the gallery to the students, we try to express to them that art is a powerful form of self-expression, and that the women in this exhibition are dealing with some very provocative and challenging social issues and content. Can you start to talk about some of those issues in the exhibition yourself?
Women, we've contributed to our communities in so many different ways. And being in the arts is just another form. And many things that we do in our lives, we don't necessarily recognize them as being art. For example, quilting. There are a lot of quilters in this exhibition and women who employ that as part of their medium. And that's not the first thing that you think of as an artist. You think of painting or drawing or something of that nature.
I know when I have talked to some of the students, I've told them, you know, that art, we respond to art and other images, and it sometimes can change the way we think about an issue. And I think this exhibition begins to address issues of war and peace, issues of racial discrimination, gender and sexual orientation discrimination, and religious intolerance.
I think what this exhibition does is that it allows the viewer different perspectives and ask questions of the viewer, and we're able to think about those questions, internalize that information, and hopefully go out and make our world a better place.
Delita, I wanted to talk to you about Amina Robinson's work because it's someone that I've been aware of for about 3 or 4 years. I really enjoy her work, and I thought this was a very compelling image. What does this image mean to you when you look at it?
I think Amina is a very amazing artist. I've looked at her work in undergraduate school, and I've, you know, referenced her work throughout my career as an artist. And what amazes me is that she's this wonderful visual storyteller, and her work is very bold and very unapologetic. And what I really enjoy is that she not only references the community and talk about the community in her work, but she uses elements from the community. I believe that as people, we leave our fingerprints in spaces and on items and on objects and things, and she brings these things into her work. So it's not only the artist who's talking about the community, but the people also have a voice in it as well.
Well, and I thought too, it was really brilliant that she brought the veil in, which the women have to wear there, and she's using the necktie from our culture to create that veil.
You know, and I think it references that about their culture, but it also references some issues that are in our culture as well, you know, with men dominating certain areas in economics and, you know, in society in general. And I thought that that was brilliant, the way she brought that into her work and brought that together as a symbol and a sign.
We're standing here at Flo Wong's piece, which is one of the sculptural pieces in the show. And I'm curious to you, what narrative begins to unfold for you as you look at this piece?
Well, it was a very emotional piece for me. Looking at this piece, the artist to me is talking about memory. She's talking about home. I couldn't imagine being in a predicament where I had to pack up and leave at a moment's notice, or given 6 days or 4 days or 3 days to leave my home, a place that I've known, a place with family and friends. So I was very emotional. When I walk up to these suitcases and I look inside the mirror, I almost become, you know, a part of the piece.
Well, and she's referencing the Japanese internment camps that were developed in America, and they were also here in Arkansas, in Jerome and Roar, in southern Arkansas. And I think her reference is to the ones in Wyoming, where they sort of rounded up all the Japanese Americans and put them in these camps.
It was a very sad time, very disturbing, I think, definitely a blemish on American history. Looking at these pieces is just so emotional. Imagine coming back years to a place that you were forced to leave from, a place that you loved, your home.
And, you know, they really didn't have a choice. They were made to
exactly
move. Right.
And if you can imagine carrying, you know, taking with you only what you could carry, and in most cases the artist referenced taking only two suitcases, I mean, could you diminish my life anymore by just having me diminish my life down to two suitcases? And that's a very profound thing.
Delita, what I find interesting about some of the women in the exhibition is their own cultural heritage. Lila has an American mother and an Iraqi father. She lived abroad, then she lived in America for 25 years, and now she lives back in the Middle East. She's still trying to find her voice. Who is she? Did you consider that when you were looking at the pieces, about who the artists were?
I did. Identity is an issue that I deal with in my own work, and, you know, I found it amazing that these women still had a voice, you know, that Lila still had a voice living in this hybrid world, in this, you know, this hybrid space where she's trying to find who she is as an artist, who she is as a woman, you know. And I thought she, you know, she portrays this in her work, and I think it's wonderful that she's exploring that idea. And I think it poses a question to a lot of women and to the audience, you know, of finding that sense of self, that sense of who you are. I'm struck by the women in numbers. All these women together, you know, signifies this stability, you know, with this united front of women. You know, they're in a country that, you know, it's war-torn, but yet we still move. The tenacity of these women, it's not just about war. You know, it talks about the times that they're in, but again, the tenacity of these women.
Delita, Lisa Farrington curated this exhibition, and she lives in New York City. One of the most violent incidents in the last 10 years was the attack on New York City on 9/11. This piece addresses that. Can you talk a little bit about Emma Amos and what she's doing in this piece?
Well, I really love this piece. It offers us a view into the artist's space physically, as well as emotionally and mentally. I remember when 9/11 happened, and for the first time, I was able to feel silence. And that was very amazing to me. You know, I'm on a busy expressway, and you hear all the noise and the morning traffic. But this particular morning, I heard nothing. And this piece reminded me of that. It took me back to that time. You could smell the fear that was all over the place. And this piece took me back to that memory.
And the piece is called Studio Air. Mm-hmm. And when you look at it, you see outlines of bodies possibly falling, burning buildings falling. And yet you see the artist and a friend in the studio, and you see other pieces in the background. I mean, it's a very complex narrative, but I think it illustrates what was going on that day. What about the use of materials like quilting materials and painting on that? Can you talk a little bit about what she's doing?
She's framing her work with the quilt, and she's painting on fabric and painting on canvas and combining these together. And I thought that that was really fascinating. And it goes back to my background and to a lot of backgrounds. If you look at a lot of women in the show, they are referencing quilting in their work. And not only does she actually quilt, but she referenced the quilts in her color and her pattern and, you know, and bringing all these things together.
When I read the essay by the curator, she talked about a pacifist tone in the exhibition. We don't see guns in many of the pieces, but we do see one in Emma's piece that's next to this. I'd like to look at that next and talk a little bit about the imagery and how she's constructed that quilt piece. We're standing in front of a piece called We, Us, Them, and Yours. Talk to us a little bit about what this piece means to you when you look at this.
Well, I look at this piece, and to me, it talks about the role, again, that women play in war, in society. And I think with the bomb that's going towards the little girl, it's showing us what could happen, what the possibilities are, and it's asking us to ask ourselves the question, you know, is this what we want? Is this our future that we can do better?
And what about the title? She elected to call it We, Us, Them, and Yours.
Well, I think a lot of times, you know, when we talk about places or countries that are at war, we want to point the finger at them. But I think that she is showing us that this could very well be us. This is us, you know. It's not a them, it's not a you, but it's an us collectively.
Delita, we're standing in front of Faith Ringgold's work in the exhibition. It's very powerful. Faith Ringgold has been doing this kind of work for a long time. Has she influenced you as an artist?
Absolutely. I've always looked at her work. I've enjoyed her story quilts and the amazing way she uses these quilts to talk about community and talk about things that are happening, you know, within the community.
What is this story being told in this piece behind us?
There's been a lot of blood, sweat, and tears within the African American community that we've contributed to America. And there have, throughout history, there have been issues with race, things that have happened to African Americans that were just absolutely appalling. And I think that she is referencing that. She's talking about, we are Americans too, and this is what you did to us.
And I know in reading about that piece, she specifically was addressing us, the force of our military. And it's interesting because it's juxtaposed to another piece in the exhibition called Weeping Woman. And she talks about women, while they don't often provoke the violence, they certainly suffer the consequences by loss of family, loss of friends, and loss of home.
She talks about the strength of women in her work. You know, we have that impact of war on us. Like you said, the loss of family, the loss of friends, you know, broken homes and things of that nature. But we're very resilient. Women very resilient in holding the family together and keeping these stories, this history going and passing it on to the next generation.
So if you were going to tell a friend to come and see this exhibition, what would you hope that they would get from the exhibition if they came here?
You know, I would want them to take a look at, you know, the stories. Listen to what these women are saying. I mean, these stories come through loud and clear. To think about their communities, think about what stories they can pass on. You know, think about war, think about peace, think about all these things as they relate to you. And I think the pieces in the show are so provocative in terms of the questions that they ask, that they pose the viewer. I think it's a wonderful thing.